our purpose is we digitalize the analog process. You have scanning, it basically replacing a blaster cast. Then you have the digital modularization, so that replaces or is a substitute for the analog modeling, the changing the shape and in an analog way, now we do it digital. Scanning is actually the entry point into the world of digitalization. But so what people start with is scanning, because what they want, you know, they don't want to run around with heavy bags of plaster, and the plaster is also quite messy process. So scanning is really important. It's the first step in the digitalization of the workflow.
Konventionell modifiziert man am Gips, man raspelt, man trägt ab, man trägt auf. Das Ganze dann im digitalen Bereich zu machen, an einem Bildschirm, wo man keine Haptik hat, das ist erstmal eine große Hürde.
We do that in a digital way, which gives you way more control, have more predictable, makes the process faster, easier and also more reliable.
In the modeling process, you're not only doing some corrections such as reductions, but you're also doing some landmarks, some basically blueprints for the device to be designed.
We need a very good user experience and easy to use software so that it's very easy to learn and get along with the software. So a user-friendly interface with clear guidance and clear workflows, that's key.
In the end, that software should be as seamless and not there as much as possible, because if they are trying to get the device and they remember the software, then we kind of did our job wrong. With TT, there was a specific tool, and it's called the reduction tool. There's a lot of information displayed to the user. They have a lot of options that they can do on the screen. In order to take all of that, bring it down to a very small side panel and have it be one, understandable, two, usable, and three, beautiful, that's a challenge.
We make the software step by step smarter with AI, and the software is, you know, helping them automating, saving time. AI is definitely, you know, supporting the expertise of a CPO, providing a level of automation. That's why I would say it.
We are aiming for an accuracy below 1 millimeter for our use cases. In order to now take all these different images we collect with the scanner, and in order to actually create a 3D object out of it, we need to have something called a 3D reconstruction. This is computationally very, very heavy. And this is a challenge to have this done effectively and in real time.
It's just a starting point where we actually lay the foundation of scanning, modulation, printing, designing, but in the end, we have a holistic platform for prosthetics and orthotics.
I think that the device is a very big step for Ottobock. The software is a huge success so far. The feedback that we're getting after the last update is great, and I'm very proud that I've been a part of that solution.
So what we do at iFab is really we transform or digitalize the work, not of the world of OMP, not for the sake of digitalization. We do that really to improve clinical outcome, change the life and help people to live normal lives. That's what we are pursuing and following.
Overall, I think what would make me happy is when the device is on a patient and the patient is happy.